Support for LAS comes from UCLA's Department of Statistics and Data Science, offering their Masters of Applied Statistics and Data Science program, which teaches advanced data science to working professionals. All courses meet in the evenings. Employees in local industries in the Los Angeles and Greater Los Angeles area are invited to apply for next fall 2025. Learn more at master.stat.ucla.edu.
Support for LAist comes from Westridge School in Pasadena, an independent girls' school for grades 4 through 12. Parents and students are welcome to attend an online info session or their open house event on Saturday, November 2nd. RSVP at westridge.org/visit.
Today on the LA Report, federal prosecutors have convened a grand jury to investigate Orange County Supervisor Andrew Do. Thousands of mental health care workers at Kaiser may go on strike Monday. And this Food Friday, the hunt to find the best breakfast burrito in LA. It's Friday, October 18th. I'm Julia Paskin, and this is the LA Report from LAist 89.3. LAist has obtained new details on a federal investigation into what happened to millions of Orange County taxpayer dollars meant to help during the pandemic. As Nick Gerda explains, a state court filing reveals for the first time that federal prosecutors have convened a federal grand jury.
The news comes after IRS and FBI agents searched homes owned by County Supervisor Andrew Do and his daughter, Rhiannon Do, as well as other houses connected to the nonprofit Viet America Society. Federal authorities have declined to say what or whom they're investigating, but Rhiannon Do's attorney filed a document in Orange County's civil fraud lawsuit in state court that reveals a federal grand jury is investigating, and federal prosecutors have subpoenaed at least two leaders of the nonprofit to testify. The attorney wrote that Rhiannon Do and other leaders at Viet America Society face, quote, the threat of criminal prosecution. Supervisor Do and Rhiannon Do have denied wrongdoing. For LAist, I'm Nick Gerda.
Meanwhile, Chris Wangsaporn, who has served as Andrew Doe's chief of staff for the last 6 years, has resigned. A county spokesperson confirmed this today. LAist reported this week on a $275,000 contract, which Wangsaporn's then-girlfriend, now wife, was hired to fulfill. County officials said while the money was fully paid out, the work was never turned into them. Wangsaporn has not responded to a phone message requesting for comment. Nearly 2,400 Kaiser Permanente mental health workers in Southern California say they are ready to start picketing on Monday if the healthcare provider cannot meet demands aimed at reducing employee turnover and improving patient care. Here is Robert Garova.
Maricela Calvillo says psychiatric counselors like her aren't given enough time to care for between 10 to 18 patients a day.
But a lot of clinicians are saying enough is enough, you know, like treat mental health like you would in every other department. Make it something that is more based off quality and not the quantity of patients.
In a statement, Kaiser said it's making preparations to ensure patients don't have gaps in service. Under state law, the HMO is required to arrange for out-of-network care if a work stoppage happens. For LAist, I'm Robert Garova.
The local for-profit Prestige Career College has ads for a free nurse assistant training program all over LA County. The neon-colored signs urge prospective students to call now, but when they do, people with convictions learn that they do not qualify. Julia Barajas has more.
Even though some training programs are exclusionary, California doesn't actually bar someone with a felony record from becoming a nurse assistant. Rebecca Oyama of the East Bay Community Law Center says the state considers many factors before certifying people with criminal records.
Who they are today, what they've done since the time of their conviction, how old it, you know, that record is.
Like Prestige, local community colleges require background checks, but students with convictions are not automatically disqualified. For LAist, I'm Julia Barajas.
Coming up in a moment, why schools in California are asking voters to approve local bond measures.
Support for LAist comes from the American French Film Festival. 1 week of French films and series premieres, October 29th through November 3rd at the Directors Guild in Hollywood. Films include The Count of Monte Cristo and an opening night gala screening of Emilia Perez, France's official selection for the Academy Awards. Free screenings and events include the short films and television competitions, happy hour talks, and an educational program. More info about the American French Film Festival is at taff.org.
Support for LAS comes from UCLA's Department of Statistics and Data Science. Their Masters of Applied Statistics and Data Science program teaches advanced data science to working professionals, blending the fundamental ideas of quantitative analysis with a modern computational approach. All courses are scheduled in the evenings. Local industries in the Los Angeles and Greater Los Angeles area are invited to partner and provide science projects. Learn more at master.stat.ucla.edu/partners.
Welcome back to the LA Report. I'm Julia Paskin. Dozens of school districts say their campuses are in bad shape, so they're asking voters this fall to approve property tax increases to fund local bonds. Sarah Hinckley researches facilities funding at UC Berkeley. She says school districts need the money for critical infrastructure like plumbing and earthquake safety.
These aren't sort of luxury renovation projects we're talking about here. We're talking about funding to get schools up to the point where they can be usable every day of the school year.
Critics of school bonds questioned why known problems like lead paint and asbestos were not fixed with previous voter-approved funding. LAist has guides to all of the K-12 bond measures on the ballot in LA and Orange County. They're online at laist.com/vote. This Food Friday, we are talking about breakfast burritos. Casey Shea is out to find the best breakfast burrito in LA, and she shares her quest with social media videos of each taste test.
Okay, let's talk about what's in here. It's very, very simple. We have scrambled eggs, hash browns, bacon, cheese. It's good, very affordable. An $8 burrito, as the good Lord intended.
Well, LAist food editor Gab Chabran caught up with Shea to talk about her review process and to find out some of the best breakfast burritos she's tried so far. You can read about that at LAist.com. Thanks for listening to the LA Report. I'm Julia Paskin. Be sure to listen again tomorrow morning for the LA Report Weekend Edition. Today's LA Report was produced by Danielle Martinez with support from Karina Gakkad. Megan Garvey is the executive editor. Catherine Mailhouse is our director of content development. Our engineer is Tui Mao. Original music by Scott Kelly. You can read more about this evening's stories at LAist.com. Listen live anytime on the LAist app or on the radio at 89.3 FM. The LA Report is made possible by listeners like you. That's why we ask you to donate at LAist.com/join so we can keep the LA Report and trusted local journalism coming your way every day. This podcast is supported by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe quality journalism makes Southern California a better place to live. Hey, it's Julia Paskin, the host of the LA Report PM edition. Before we start this episode, I wanted to let you know that LAist's Fall Member Drive is happening right now, which means your donation is crucial to helping us raise the funding necessary to keep local news strong. Because when you give $5 or $10 a month of support, you're investing in trustworthy news about our community. So please donate today at LAist.com/join, and thank you.